Hey fam, today I've got a highly anticipated video for you all. I'm going to show you not only how to create animated characters like we've seen before, but also how to add some awesome assets to make our animations even cooler. Stick around till the end of the video to find out how. Let's go! Here's the flow and tools we'll use. Designing characters and assets with RenderNet using its Canvas feature. Background removal with Canva, this part is optional. Then create 3D models with 3DA Studio, animate characters with Mixamo, and finally add the assets to the character and create the final animation with Blender. You'll find all the prompts and links to the apps I've used in the video descriptions, so smash that like button, save this video for easy access, and subscribe to the channel for more guides like this on using AI in your creative processes. I'm preparing a complete workflow for creating your own video games with Godot using AI. So let's head to RenderNet. As we've seen in previous videos, we'll use Canvas, which is perfect for having all our concept art easily accessible and organized. Let's start by creating our character's face. We'll use the DynaVision XL model, perfect for this kind of job. With this prompt, portrait, close-up, illustration of a barbarian male, long black beard and blue eyes, stoic, concept art, front view looking at viewer. Set the aspect ratio to 1:1, click generate and wait for our result. Once it's ready, right-click on it, set your character's face with face lock, and then it's time to create our character in a T-pose, ideal for later animating it with Mixamo. Enable Control Net, upload a T-pose image you can find on Google, and use this prompt. Full body illustration of a barbarian male, long black beard and blue eyes, stoic concept art, front view looking at viewer. With an aspect ratio of 2:3, then click generate and you're done. Now let's create the assets we'll include in our animation, like a sword and helmet. Use this prompt, a barbarian sword made of steel, glowing arcane effect, concept art, gray background. Play around with the aspect ratio as needed. So now, with our character and accessories ready, head to 3DA Studio to turn them into 3D models. It's as easy as uploading the image and generating the model. Once ready, do a remesh to convert it to FBX, the file type we can handle in both Mixamo and Blender. Download the models, go to Mixamo, and I'll show you again how we animate it. Upload the 3D character model, set it facing forward, set key skeleton points, and once loaded, pick from the animations Mixamo offers. Download your choice. Perfect! We now have our characters, 3D animation, and the elements to incorporate. How? In Blender? Super simply. Import the three elements into the scene, position and scale the assets, like the helmet and sword, to fit the character correctly. Then integrate them with the rig so they move with the animation. For this, select the armature, switch to pose mode by pressing Ctrl plus Tab, select the nearest bone first, then the asset with Ctrl, and then press Ctrl plus P to link it to the rig. Repeat for each element and voila! Our animation is ready with assets included. And this is just the beginning. We can add particle effects, try different lighting, anything we want. But we'll cover that in a future video since, as I mentioned earlier, I'm setting up a complete workflow to create video games with Godot using AI as a key creative tool, speeding up the process tremendously. But in the meantime, check out the rest of the videos on my channel and leave comments on what you'd like to learn next. Also, a huge thanks to you all. We hit over 3,000 subscribers in just 2 months since I started posting videos consistently, which really motivates me to keep going. See you in the next video. Tech Hala signing off. Bye bye, guys.